Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be showing you guys my updated dollhouse tour of 2015. I decided to rearrange it into a different room since it was so cluttered in my closet, so let's get started. So first we're going to start with the American Girl living room, and these are chairs from a tutorial from My Froggy Stuff. And here we have a coffee table, and it's from a drawer. We have a remote control for PlayStation or anything like that. And it's actually an eraser from my local book fair, which I don't go to anymore because I'm not elementary anymore. We have a type of like terrarium, and it's just Easter grass, hand sanitizer in it, and glitter. And surprisingly, the scent of the hand sanitizer is still there from about a year ago, so. Then we have a Kit Kitteridge little movie thing I made. Sorry about my nail. I put fake nails on and just kind of did that. So yeah, and I made this a while back as well with my friend. And the top up here from the drawer, it's actually cardboard with fabric around it, and that's my sister's doll, just so you know. Moving on to the kitchen, we have the kitchen, and I have a kitchen tour somewhere in my page. It's not from long ago as well, so there's nothing really to say about this. Here we have the dining room, and it's just the American Girl dining dinner table, whatever it is. I'm sorry. And then we have the breakfast set, and this is one of the cutest sets ever. I have a review on this, just remember, look at my page. Then, moving on, we are in Abby's room. Finally, I made a room for her. So I have an American Girl box. And then a shirt as the covers, and then I have some Our Generation pillows. And since it's blue, Abby loves blue, why not make it a blue shirt? Then we have a nightstand. This is from Julie's bed room, like wholesale. This is Abby's soccer bag and a Rubik's Cube with a Rebecca book. It's actually pretty cute. You can get that from the mini doll or the American Girl school set. Here's Abby, and here's her hamster named Pinky. I made this a long time ago and still kept it and decided it could be good for Abby. I also have this little sign that says Abby on it. You can probably find it at Hobby Lobby. I honestly don't know. In these drawers, what I was talking about earlier, the coffee table, there's a missing one right here. So I just put clothes that don't come in American Girl boxes. And then right here, from the canvas shoe box, I keep some purses. Moving on, we are going to Caroline's room, and you know Caroline is just the top girly one in the whole family. So we have Julie's rabbit here, and this is actually my sister's rabbit, but you know, she let me borrow it sometimes. We have this foot rug, and I think it's really cute. And here it's a little like heart, and all I do, there's Julie right there, my sister's doll. All I keep in here, I'm sorry. Just the struggle opening this. I'm gonna move on while I try to open this. Here I have some nail polishes, cause you know, Caroline, girly as always. And then in here, I don't think I have anything in here except down here. I have a recorder and a folder. These are stacked up together for purposes. And I'll be showing you, oh God, let's just, there, I opened it. Okay, here I just keep my American Girl bracelets, and I think these are really cute. Okay, and then we have a little kit doll right here in Julie's bed. I have an American Girl bag here, and you can get them from buying something really small from American Girl. In here I just have some meat outfits from my American Girl 2011 dolls. Here's a little backpack, and I actually got this at Claire's, and I just really needed this once I found it, because why not, guys? Let's open it. In here, we have some papers and that kind of stuff. I'll probably make a better tutorial later on. Now we're at Emily's room, and all it is this bed I got from eBay. eBay. And I don't regret getting this because it's a perfect bed. All I need is just to get some bedspread for her. And her favorite color is purple, as you can see, because, you know, her room is just Ooh, purple. We have a, I think it's, yeah, an Our Generation headphones MP3 player, I guess. I don't even know myself. I have the mini doll Ruthie. And I have this cute little nightstand that I got from Hobby Lobby. And in here, it stores nothing for now until I begin to store stuff. I have this little tissue box that I made a while back. And this is the most cutest and best thing I've ever made. When I made this, it was like completely sucky, but it actually turned out pretty good and it was really hard. Then this is the small real terrarium from Julie's bed set. Oops, okay. And then right here in the corner, we have the American Girl backpack set that's Emily's. Anyways, moving on. Now we have the best, probably the best room ever besides Caroline, is McKenna's room. So beginning up here, we have a glass peace sign. You can probably see the camera if I move her. There you go. And I have these beds, a mattress and bedspread from Our Generation. Down here, we have the small little desk. And FYI, my dad made this. Like, this, yeah, the whole thing. My dad made it with me. Instead of spending, I don't know how much money American Girl put for the normal bed, we made it cheaper by building our own way. And I love how it just ended up. On the table, we have McKenna's journal from her accessories. And it's actually a really cute journal, in my opinion. Then I have a calculator from the American Girl school set. I have her accessories. And I'll probably soon make a closer video on what's inside. I have this chair that I made. An American Girl gymnast loom, I guess. I have an American Girl cup with some pencils that I made. And some duct tape. Because you know, what girl doesn't like duct tape? Probably you guys. Anyways, I have this Ruthie book that came from the mini doll. Oops, my bad. And this is a small shelf as well. We have her phone, and this is an eraser from a book fair, and I don't think they do these in middle school anymore. And then we have a small little box, and it's full of squinkies, because who doesn't like squinky, guys? And down here we have Star. It's mainly McKenna's pet. Yeah, it's McKenna's pet. And there's some food with a cookie and a bone. It just looks adorable. Okay, moving on. We have the bathroom. Let me tell you guys something. This bathroom, don't even like judge it already, because I am not done. I still have to make a toilet and a shower and oh my god, who knows. I've already like tried making the sink, but you know how there's that kind of stuff? I need to wrap it in paper and make it all better because it's just terrible. I need to add a faucet, so don't even like look at this. Last room is Sage's room, and this is a pet she owns. She owns a little cute kitten, and I think it's really cute and it moves. Aw man, no battery? That sucks. You've had it for years. Anyways. Here we have her little backpack. This is the cutest thing ever. There's some stuff inside like gum. And it's a cute puppy, also gotten at Claire's. And then this is like a little, I don't know what it is, but a realtor gave it to us when we moved into her house. Here we have some duct tape rolls, and you know how she's artsy and all. We have her paints. And then some other stuff right here, like one of Caroline's main dresses, and there's nothing over there. So this is like, I don't even know what it would be. And then we have Sage's sketchbook, and you get this when you go to the opening. This is the bed, and this is actually a dress. Sage's favorite color is orange, so I decided to use this dress that I was never ever gonna use ever again. So same with this bed, got it from eBay, and pretty proud of this set right here that I invented. We have also two other duct tape rolls and Meet Kit book with Julie's nightstand. And that's it, guys. Like, literally, if you walk around the room, there's a big window here. And that's just all the rooms of the dolls. I'll show you a huge, like, what's up, guys? See? Let me stand up on this chair. Oh god, I'm afraid I'm gonna fall off. see you guys. Like, I hope I get other dolls, and if I do, I will have more space, because, you know, it could be another one right here, right there, or right there or something. But yeah, one day I have a wish that this room would get rid of, so it'd be easier instead of, like, you know, way over here. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Tell me what you think of this dollhouse. And if you haven't seen my other dollhouse, okay, I want you guys to do this. If you haven't seen my other dollhouse, go look at that tour and then compare it. Which one did you like better, this dollhouse or the other one? If you already seen it, then it's easy to compare. So guys, please comment below what dollhouse is better. I think this one's better. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Please do a big thumbs up and comment any questions you have. Remember, I'll do a giveaway once I hit 3,000. Love you.